gift that's also meaningful, we may have found an answer for you.
How about an authentic doll made by a local teen? But this young lady has a very special story.
15-year-old Ariel Turner is a doll maker.
I think it's special because I'm 15, and most 15-year-olds don't really know how to sew or make dolls.
Ariel has designed and sewn some 50 dolls to date.
First, I draw the head out. Then, I draw the head and the ears together. Then, I draw the arms. Then, I draw the body. Then, I draw the legs. They're all separate.
Next, she concentrates on the face with embroidery and then puts the nose on last.
And then I'll look around for old costumes, like old stuff that I don't wear anymore, and I'll use that as the clothes.
Ariel's parents are continually amazed.
She is a perfectionist. She's never satisfied with them, you know, but we are, most people are when they see them.
Ariel made these twin dolls in the likeness of herself and twin brother, Max. Her mother really loves these dolls that Ariel named the Fisher family.
She pieced together old skirt, old leather sandal. And then eventually we had some seashells around the house, so she did seashells. So the mother has a seashell on her ear. The father's catching fish, frogs. And it's just amazing how she come up with the ideas.
Ariel started making dolls when she was 12, right after she was diagnosed with an inoperable rare brain tumor. Half of it is cancerous.
I needed something to get my mind off things.
Before the tumor, she played piano, took art lessons, and more. But the tumor makes her tired, has affected her eyesight and mobility.
The memory problems, like I'm trying to learn Japanese, and sometimes I forget some of the stuff in there, and I get really mad.
There's more to this doll story. Ariel hopes to sell her dolls so that she can help her family out financially.
Ariel's father, Mark, is battling prostate and bladder cancer. Her mother, Tina, suffers from lupus and has diabetes. Both cannot work and are on disability. Still, Tina homeschools Ariel's brother, Max, who is autistic.
The stuff she made as a hobby, like dolls and jewelry, was a hobby. She says she wants to sell them. And so she started trying to sell them to sort of help us out financially. And I mean, what more can you ask for from a kid to take you seriously? Because it's our responsibility to provide for the children.
Ariel's dolls are for sale at the Woman's Industrial Exchange on Charles Street. She wants them to sell, but even more, she wants the people who buy them to adore them.
I hope that they're happy and that they like them.
And people have been happy and liking them because right after the story originally aired, they sold out of all the dolls in the store.
Wow.
She brought some others in the next day. A lady came in from New York City. People waited 4 hours for her to get there so they could sign autographs and she could sign the dolls. But I have to say, so many people have donated money and other resources to the family. It's just a blessing to see how Baltimore has come out for her, and her family is so pleased after being at death's door so many times this year.
That's wonderful.
So
it is wonderful.
Keep the gifts coming.
Well, it's time. It's